Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Namaham Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the pastimes of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who traveled everywhere in the material and spiritual world.
We 他既去了物质世界,又在整个灵性世界周游了一圈。
And his travels were told by Maharaj Parikshit to his mother, Uttara.
他的整个历程是由 Maharaj Parikshit 给自己的母亲 Uttara 讲述的。
So Maharaj Parikshit wanted to fully explain to his mother the very important position of Vrindavan and the people of Vrindavan. So he's doing this by repeating the prayers of Lord Brahma, which Lord Brahma had offered to Krishna after the Brahma Vimohan Lila, after Lord Brahma had been put into illusion.
Brahma 维摩哈利拉就是Brahma被迷惑的消失光发生之后，Brahma献上的祈祷文。
So at that time, Brahma had realized the very elevated position of the people of Vrindavan and the holy place of Vrindavan.
在那一时刻，Brahma就意识到了
So this is the final prayer, actually. Today we're going to read the final prayer offered by Lord Brahma.
那接下来我们将阅读 Brahma 向 Krishna 献上的最后一段祈祷。
So Lord Brahma is congratulating Krishna that you give happiness to the people of the Vrishni dynasty.
Brahma 开始祝贺主 Krishna 说你给 Vishnu 家族 Vishnu 王朝带来了快乐。
And you also bring happiness to the whole planet and the demigods and the brahmanas and the cows.
而且你也给整个星球 给半神人们，给婆罗门和母牛带来了快乐。
And by your presence, you remove the darkness of irreligion.
通过你的临在，你去除了非宗教的黑暗。
And you're always against the demons who come on this earth.
你也总是在反对来到这个地球上的那些恶魔。
So Lord Brahma prays to Krishna, as long as this universe exists, and as long as the sun shines,I will offer my obeisances to you.
Brahma 就这样赞美主 Krishna 说，只要宇宙还仍将存在，只要太阳仍然发光，那么我将向你献上最虔敬的祈祷。
So Lord Brahma is comparing Krishna to both the sun and the moon.
就这样 ，Brahma 把 Krishna 既比喻为太阳，又比喻为月亮。
Krishna is like the sun because he brings happiness to the lotus flower of the Vrishni dynasty.
Krishna 之所以被比喻为太阳，是因为他就给像莲花一样的 Vrishni 王朝带来了快乐。
And he's like the moon because he brings strength and nourishment.To the earth and to the demigods and the brahmanas and the cows.
而 Krishna 被比喻为月亮，是因为他给地球、半神人、婆罗门和母牛带来了力量和滋养。
And he's like the sun and the moon, and because he opposes the darkness of irreligion.
Krishna 被比喻为日月，是因为他。反对非宗教的黑暗。
And he stops the power of the Rakshasas like Kamsa.
他阻止了 Kamsa 这样的 Rakshasa 的力量。
But then Brahma considers that actually, if you compare Krishna to the sun and the moon, it doesn't give him full justice. It's not really enough to glorify Krishna.
然后 Brahma 又进一步重申说，即便把 Krishna 比喻为日月，也不能充分彰显他的荣耀。
Brahma says that actually Krishna deserves to be worshipped by the sun. He should be worshipped by everyone, including the sun.
Brahma 说，实际上 Krishna 甚至值得太阳的崇拜，他值得众生的崇拜。
And that's why Brahma promises to offer his obeisances to Krishna until the end of the millennium, which is the end of the day of Brahma.
正因为这个原因 ，Brahma 发誓要一直顶拜主 Krishna， 直到 Brahma 的这个寿命，他的整个的寿命结束为止。
So in this way, Brahma is offering his glorification of his master, Lord Krishna.
就这样 ，Brahma 就向他的主人圣主 Krishna 献上荣耀。
So just as the sun takes away the darkness of night and opens the lotus flower.So Krishna appearing on the planet also lets the devotees know that the demons are going to get trouble, they're going to be destroyed.
正如旭日东升，黑暗尽去，太阳能唤醒人们，并且让莲花盛开。所以 ，Krishna 在这个星球上显现，就是为了告知那些地球上的恶魔们，他们的麻烦来了，他们即将被毁灭。
So when Krishna appeared, Lord Vasudev, Krishna's father, he was so effulgent that it was very difficult for anybody to actually see him.
当主 Krishna 显现的时候，他光芒四射，每个人几乎都睁不开眼睛，没办法直接目视他。
Even powerful people like Kamsa, they could not approach him. They could not understand. They could not see him.
甚至像康萨这样强有力的君王，也无法接近主Krishna，也无法看清楚他。
And when the demigods, when Mother Devaki and Vasudeva were in the prison of Kamsa, at that time the demigods came to offer prayers to the Lord in the womb of Devaki.
当Krishna母亲 Devaki 和他的父亲 Vasudeva 被关在监狱的时候，那个时候半神人们就来监狱探望还在 Devaki 子宫当中的至尊主，并献上祈祷。And
they prayed to the Lord that we're very fortunate because you have come to remove all these demons, all the burden of these demons on the earth.
半神祈祷说：“我们至为幸运，因为您降临地球，来铲除恶魔，来减轻地球上的重负。”And
the demigods said, "We're very fortunate because we'll be able to see your lotus footprints on this earth planet."
半神们说：“我们非常幸，我们至为幸运，因为我们能看到您在这个地球上。”
And the demigods also prayed to Devaki that because of your good fortune and also our good fortune, that's why Krishna, along with Baladev, have now come to this planet. And they're going to appear on this planet Earth.
也由于我们的好运，所以主 Krishna 和 Balarama 就显现在这个地球星球。And
the demigods told Devaki, "You don't have to fear Kamsa, because we know he's going to be killed by Krishna."
半神们安慰 Devaki 说：“你不用恐惧 Kamsa， 因为我们知道 Krishna 一定会杀掉他。”And
your son Krishna will be the protector of the entire Yadu dynasty.
您的儿子将是整个亚度王朝的保护者。
And the same, when Krishna was about to be born, then Sukadeva Goswami described how all the towns and all the fields and the earth is all seem very auspicious.
当 Krishna 出生之际，Sukadeva Goswami 描述说，所有的城镇、所有的田野，还有整个的地球都呈现出吉祥的景象。When
the earth is prosperous, then all the people on the earth they're also prosperous. And all the brahmanas and all the animals, they're all prosperous.
一旦地球呈现出欣欣向荣的景象，那居住在地球上的人类、婆罗门和动物也都会过上繁荣幸福的生活。And
Brahma, he wants to give importance, that he said that Krishna has special feeling for the cows and the brahmanas.
Brahma 着重强调的是 Krishna 特别的喜爱婆罗门和母牛。
And Krishna gave Brahma also pure love. He gave Brahma pure love. It was given by Krishna himself.
Krishna 也把对他自己的纯粹的爱赐给了 Brahma.
And Brahma is showing his gratitude to Krishna for this.
为此, Brahma 对 Krishna 感激不尽。
So, because Krishna performed the Rasa-lila and other pastimes, so Krishna, he took away the gopis' ignorance and fear.
因为 Krishna 他上演了 Rasa 之舞的逍遥时光以及其他的逍遥时光，他就这样拿走了勾品们的愚昧和恐惧。
But when Brahma is offering his prayers, at that time Krishna had not performed his pastimes with the gopis yet.
但是当主 Brahma 向 Krishna 献上祈祷的时候 ，Krishna 在那个时候还没有跟 gopis 们上演这些逍遥时光。
But Brahma knows, he knows past, present, and future. So when he speaks, it's like these pastimes have already taken place.
Brahma, 他无所不知，他知道过去、现在和未来。所以当 Brahma 说这番话的时候，就好像这些逍遥时光已经上演了。
So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna says that real religious principles, true religious principles, are whatever brings one to devotional service.
在圣殿伯加瓦坛当中，主 Krishna 说，真正的宗教原则是能够给人们带来奉爱的原则。
And things like karma and jnana and other things, they only deviate people from pure devotional service.
而功利性活动 karma 和Giana 思辨只会让人们偏离纯粹的奉献服务。
So real religious principles are in the form of pure devotion to Krishna, but it is often hidden. Just like sometimes you have a lot of treasure, will be kept hidden in a cave.
真正的宗真正的宗教原则就是纯粹的奉爱，它是以一种隐蔽的方式存在着的，就好像山洞里一个人有大量珠宝的时候，会把它们藏在山洞里。
So even people may come to visit the cave, they may not notice all these other, may not notice the valuable treasure, because they just see so many other things there, they're not able to see what's really valuable.
当人们来拜访山洞的时候，他们找不到这些宝藏，因为他们只会看到别的事物，而看不到真正的宝藏。
So these different religious systems, they're just like some kinds of darkness. But by Krishna coming to earth, he's taking them away, he's taking the darkness away, and he's bringing the light of perfect knowledge, perfect religion.
这些不同的宗教体系只是黑暗而已。当 Krishna 莅临地球的时候，他会拿走这些黑暗，把完美的知识和完美的宗教的光芒带给地球。
In the night, you get people who are like Rakshasas, who like to eat human flesh. So these people, they're like people.These Rakshasas are like people who follow the wrong kinds of religious principles. They don't follow real bhakti, but they follow some other things.
当夜幕降临的时候，那些吃人肉的 Rakshasas 就会异常的活跃。这些人他们是遵循的是错误的宗教原则，他们不会去遵守 bhakti 原则。
So these kinds of religion are things like people like karmis and jnanis. So they also live here on earth, and they're practicing the path of karma and jnana. So this is actually opposed to real devotion.
那些果报工作者们 ，karmi 和思辨主义者 ，jnani， 他们在地球上，他们修行的是果报工作和思辨，他们反对的是真正的奉爱。
And there are other rakshasas, then people like the enemies of the vrishnis and the enemies of the devotees, enemies like Kamsa and his people.
还有其他的 Rakshas 食人魔，他们是 Vishnu 王朝的敌人，奉献者的敌人，像 Kamsa 这样的人。
And there are demons like Shankachuta and Aristasura. They try to disturb Krishna's rasa dance and other pastimes.
还有像 Shankachuta 和 Aristasura 这样的恶魔们，他们反对 Krishna 的 rasa 之舞和 Krishna 其他的消时光。
But Krishna destroyed all these different demons.
Krishna 把这些不同的恶魔都一并铲除了。
So only Krishna is able to do these things, to show the real position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
这些奇迹只有 Krishna 才能上演，他展示了至尊性格神首的真正的地位。
So Krishna appears on the earth to perform these pastimes never shown before, even by Lord Narayan or any of his incarnations.
Krishna 降临到地球上来展示这些消时光，而这些是像主 Narayana 和主的其他化身以前从未展示过的。
So Krishna is like the enemy of, he's the enemy of people who are his relatives, like his uncle Kamsa. So it seems like Krishna is going against religious principles by having an enemy in the form of his uncle.
Kamsa is Krishna's 亲戚，是 Krishna 的舅舅，可是 Krishna 却变成了他的敌人，好像。Krishna 这样是违反了宗教原则，因为他成了他亲舅舅的敌人。
So we may think, Krishna is not pious. He should be friendly to his uncle. So it means he's not following moral principles.
这么做好像 Krishna 就缺乏虔诚一样，因为他并没有对 Kamsa。展示友好，他好像并没有遵守道义。
But Brahma said, "No, Krishna is Bhagavan, and whatever he does is for the good of everyone."
但是 Brahma 矢口否认了，他说不是 ，Krishna 是 Bhagavan， 他是每个人的祝福者。
And even the people who are very much attached to karma and jnana, although they have the nature of demons.Krishna deals with them in a way that will help them to become devotees.
甚至那些遵守 karma、jnana 或功利性活动和思辨道路的恶魔们 ，Krishna 跟他们的交往方式也是为了帮助他们。
And to the most vicious demons like Kamsa, Krishna is even more merciful.Because he gives them liberation by killing them.
对于最邪恶的恶魔，比如说 Kamsa, Krishna 对他反而是更最仁慈的，因为他赐予了他解脱，杀死了他。
And the commentators say that Krishna deserves the worship of everyone because.Even those who are very attached to karma and jnana, they come to bhakti. People like Akrura and Bhishma, they were not much devotees, but they became devotees by the mercy of Krishna.
Krishna 值得人人的崇拜，甚至那些依附 karma、依附 jnana 的人也能来到 bhakti 的层面，像Akrura 和 Bhishma。这些并非真正的奉献者的人最终也成为了奉献者。
And demons like Kamsa, they've also come to devotional service because they're always absorbed in thinking of you.
像 Kamsa 的这样的恶魔们 最后也达到了份爱，因为他恒常地想念着你。
Of course, Kamsa meditated on Krishna, but meditated on Krishna as his enemy.
Kamsa 一直恒常地冥想 Krishna, 但是却把 Krishna 当成自己的死敌来冥想。
So, by killing them, Krishna brought them to life and gave them liberation.
通过杀死他 ,Krishna给予了他们解脱。
Even when Krishna is killing Kamsa and other demons, it's not happened yet. It's going to happen. So Brahma he's describing this before it takes place.
嗯 ，Brahma 描述这些种种事件的时候。那 Krishna 还没有杀死 Kamsa 和其他的恶魔，在这个事件发生之前 ，Brahma 就已经把这些事件一一进行了描述。
So because Krishna delivered the non-devotees, Lord Brahma said, "This shows how Krishna should be worshipped by everyone."
因为 Krishna 他拯救了非奉献者们，所以 Brahma 说。下结论说 ，Krishna 值得众生的每一个生物的崇拜。
So Brahma is getting ready to leave Vrindavan, so he's offering his prayers to Krishna, and he's also offering his respects to all the Brijbasi people.
Brahma 现在准备离开 Vrindavan 了，所以他在临行之前向主 Krishna 献上祈祷，也赞美了 Brijbasi。
Now in Vrindavan, there are many important trees, but there's one tree which is the least important. It's not considered very special or very useful. It's called the Arka tree.
在 Vrindavan 有许多重要的树，但是有一种树木是最微不足道的，它的名字是 Arka 树。
It doesn't have any fruits, it doesn't give any flowers, it's not useful for Krishna's worship. But Brahma offers obeisances to everyone, even to this Arka tree.
This Arka tree doesn't have any fruits, it doesn't give any flowers, it doesn't even use it to worship. But Brahma, even to this Arka tree,树也献上了顶拜，所以他顶拜了每一个生物。
Yeah, Brahma said, "I bow down to Krishna, and I bow down to everyone living in Krishna's abode. Doesn't matter if they're moving or not moving."
主 Brahma 说，我顶拜主 Krishna， 我顶拜 Krishna 居所当中的每一个生物，无论他们是动与不动的生物。
Yeah, earlier Brahma had prayed in the beginning of his prayers, he prayed that he would consider his greatest fortune to take any kind of birth in this forest of Vrindavan.
Brahma 就祈祷说，如果他能投生在这个 Vrindavan 森林，即便是投生为任何一个生物，他都会感到自己至为幸运。
Because Brahma said, all the residents of this forest, even the Arka tree, are better devotees of Krishna than I am.
Brahma 说，这个森林当中的所有的居民，即便是这个 Arka 树，也是比我更好的奉献者。
So Brahma says, I have no qualification to take a birth here. I'm not qualified like any of them.
Brahma 就自叹弗如说，我没有任何资格投生在这里。
So in this way, Brahma prays, I can never offer enough obeisances to you.
因此 ，Brahma 就这样。向 Krishna 祈祷说，我只能向你献上虔敬的祈祷。
So this is a Maharaj Parikshit's been telling these prayers of Lord Brahma to his mother because they glorify Vrindavan and all the people of Vrindavan. So now Maharaj Parikshit is going to tell a verse spoken by Krishna, Krishna speaking to his brother Balaram.
现在 Parikshit 大君呢，将 讲述 Krishna 和他的哥哥 Balarama 吟出的一个诗节。
And Krishna praises Balaram as the most glorious, the greatest person, and describes the wonderful good fortune of the other Brijbasi people.
Krishna 赞扬了 Balarama, 说他是最伟大的、最光荣的人物。他也赞扬了 Brijbasi 的其他居民的幸运。
So when Krishna was in his Poganda age that means like 5 to 10, is wandering around Vrindavan taking care of the cows.
Krishna 在跑根的年龄段，也就是5到10岁期间，他就在 Vrindavan 漫游。
So Krishna was eager to say something about the good qualities of Vrindavan, but he didn't want to praise himself. So Krishna, instead of speaking about himself, he praised Balaram.
Krishna 渴望来描述 Vrindavan 的优秀品质，但是他不想自夸，所以他就赞扬了 Balaram.
So that's a good example to others, that we should show respect to our elders. Balaram is Krishna's elder. And we should know also that whatever Krishna says about Balarama is also true for him.
无论 Krishna 对于 Balarama 所说的、说出的任何赞美，都是名副其实的。
So Krishna praises Balaram that the earth has become very fortunate because you've touched the grass and the bushes with your feet.
Krishna 赞扬 Balarama 说，这个地球太幸运了，因为 您用您的足触碰了那些草和那些丛灌木丛。
And you touch the trees and the creepers with your hands and fingers.
您用您的手莲花手和您的手指触碰了温达文的树木和温达文的爬藤。
And just by your glancing on the rivers and the mountains and the animals, you've given them your mercy.
仅仅是通过铁士、河流、山川，还有那些动物们，您就给予了他们仁慈。
And most important of all, you embraced the gopis between your two arms, which was never given, a blessing which was never given to the goddess of fortune.
除此之外，最为重要的是，您用您强有力的臂膀拥抱了勾皮们，而这一种好运是甚至幸运女神都没有得到的祝福。So
the earth planet has been doing service for Krishna since time immemorial.
因此，这个地球从无始以来，这个地球就服务了至尊主 Krishna.
Many different incarnations and representatives of Krishna have appeared on the earth.
Krishna 的不同化身和不同的代表都显现于这个地球。
And long ago, Lord Varaha picked up the earth from the bottom of the universe, and he accepted the earth as his wife.
在很久很久以前，主瓦拉哈从把地球从宇宙的底部举了起来，他接受地球为自己的妻子。
And Lord Ananta Shesha also has the earth planet.Perpetually, always on one of his hoods.
而 Ananta Shesh 永远的把地球顶在他其中的一个头棚上。
But it's only now, with the appearance of Krishna, that the Mother Earth, the Earth planet, has become the most fortunate.
但是只有当主 Krishna 显现在地球上的时候，这个地球才显得最为幸运。
So the greatest wealth is actually to have religious merit, and the highest religious principle is to develop prema bhakti.
Somewhere there's a break.
Oh.Okay, the greatest wealth is to be religious, to be pious in religion.
最伟大的财富是拥有虔诚心，就是宗教的虔诚是一个人最大的功德。
And the most important, the goal of Dharma is to develop prema bhakti, love for Krishna.
而 Dharma 的目标天职的目标是发展 prema bhakti, the Krishna 的奉爱。
So real religious principles, they should bring people to devotional service.
真正的宗教原则是能够将人带到奉爱服务当中的宗教原则。
So because Krishna has appeared on the earth, so the earth has gained the opulence of pure love of God.
因为 Krishna 显现于地球，所以地球得到了 prema 这个最重要的财富。
So other forms of wealth like economic development, sense gratification, liberation, they're not important. They're insignificant compared to pure love of God.
而其他的财富形式，比如说经济发展、感官享乐和解脱。就显得不那么重，比起对主的纯粹的奉爱就不那么重要了。
So in this way, Lord Krishna is describing that the plants and the trees and the bushes and the grass, that on this earth planet, they're more fortunate than anything on the heavenly planets.
Krishna 就这样来描述说这个这里的树木、植物、灌木，还有那些小草，它们使地球都比天堂更加幸运。
They are more fortunate because Krishna has come as a cowherd boy, and so he's touching these things with his feet.
它们之所以更加幸运，是因为 Krishna 以牧牛。一个牧牛童的身份来到了这里，他触碰了他们。
Just like previously, Lord Ramachandra, when he was in exile in the forest, he was also touching the different plants and grass and trees.
就像以前的年代，当主 Ramachandra 被流放到森林当中的时候，他也触碰了。植物、草丛和树木。
But now with Krishna and Balaram appearing, then all the plants, all the different vegetation on the earth planet, has become the most fortunate.
而现在 Krishna 和 Balaram 降临到这个地球的时候， 这里的植物还有蔬菜便已经成为最幸运的生物了。
So it may sound like Krishna is praising the earth, but he's actually glorifying Vrindavan.
听上去好像 Krishna 一直在赞美着地球，但事实上 Krishna 是在荣耀 Vrindavan。
Because when Krishna was a young boy, he displayed his pastimes, taking care of the cows, taking them all over Vrindavan. So he knows everything about Vrindavan.
In Krishna, 还是小，作为一个小男孩，他就一直在 Vrindavan 照料着母牛，所以他了解 Vrindavan 的方方面面。
So even more fortunate than the plants and bushes and grass are the trees, for because Krishna will pick their fruits and flowers and take their leaves and so on for decorating his body.
对于那些植物、灌木和草丛更幸运的是文达文的树木，因为主 Krishna 会摘取这些树上的鲜花、水果。甚至树叶来装饰自己的身体。
So he touches them with his hands, so they're very fortunate.
因为 Krishna 亲手触碰了他这些树木，所以这些树木是非常幸运的。
But even more fortunate are the rivers like Yamuna, and the mountains like Govardhan, and the birds like the peacocks.
但是更为幸运的。是文达文的河流雅木的河以及高尔丹山和像孔雀这样的鸟类。
Because Krishna is giving mercy to them just simply by looking on them.
因为 Krishna 仅仅通过瞥视他们就给予了他们仁慈。
Now of course we could say, well, Krishna looks everywhere, he sees everywhere all over Vrindavan.But he gives special affection for these things.
我们可以说，Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的时候，他是他的目光是落在了四面八方。但是，而上述的这些目标呢，是最幸运的，是 Krishna 的挚爱。
Yeah, because these things like the rivers and the mountains and the birds and the forest.They give a special pleasure to Krishna.
这条河、这座山、还有这类鸟、还有这座森林，给主 Krishna 带来的特殊的快乐。
Krishna enjoys taking bath in the river and drinking the water of the river.
Krishna 享受在这条河当中沐浴，并且喝饮清澈的河水。
And he enjoys climbing the mountains and also going in the caves of the mountains.
Krishna 也特别喜欢爬这座山，并且在这个山洞当中休息。
And he enjoys playing with the different birds and the animals in the forest.
Krishna 也享受在这个和这个森林当中的鸟类和动物们玩耍。
So, but because Krishna associates with the Yamuna and with Giri Govardhan, then they're the most fortunate servants of Krishna.
Because Krishna and this Govardhan Mountain and the Yamuna River are united, so they are Krishna's most fortunate servants.
The other rivers and mountains in Vrindavan also get Krishna's favor, but not to the same extent as the Yamuna and Govardhan.
Vrindavan 的其他的河流和山脉也得到了 Krishna 的宠幸，但是程度不一样，并不像 Yamuna 河、Govardhan 山那样受到 Krishna 那么多的宠爱。
So the animals in the forest of Vrindavan, they also get the opportunity to see the lotus feet of Krishna and and for Krishna glances over them, giving them mercy.
Vrindavan 的其他的树木，其他的动物们也看得到机会来观看主 Krishna 的莲花族，并且得到了 Krishna 瞥视的仁慈。
He will call out to them, and he will pick up their feathers, and sometimes he will touch them, and there will be nice, gentle dealings between Krishna and the different birds and animals.
Krishna 会呼唤他们，会拾起他们身上的羽毛，并且触碰他们。Krishna 对他们是非常友好、温柔的，对这些动物和鸟类。
But it's the earth who's the most fortunate because Krishna's lotus feet mark the surface of the earth.
但是大地是最幸运的，因为 Krishna 的莲花 ，Krishna 把他莲花族的足迹留在了大地的表面。
And of course, all the grass and the different bushes and plants growing on the ground.They also get the opportunity to be touched by Krishna's lotus feet, but that's an opportunity which is never given to the big trees and the big plants.
温达文的草还有灌木以及那里的植物们也得到了 Krishna 莲花族的触碰。这种机会甚至是连那些苍天那些大树和那些比较大型的植物也得不到的这种机会。
But even more fortunate are the cowherd boys and the cows because they get an opportunity to be with Krishna more.
但是那些男孩子和母牛们是更加幸运。因为他们有更多的机会来服务 Krishna.
And the most fortunate of all are the gopis, because their hearts are always drawn, always attached to Krishna.
最为幸运的是 gopi 们，因为他们的心是始终被 Krishna 所吸引，并且依附 Krishna.
So although Krishna is glorifying the earth, he actually wants to glorify Vrindavan.More than the earth.
表面上看 ，Krishna 在荣耀着地球，但实际上 ，Krishna 的目的是要荣耀 Vrindavan， 更甚于荣耀这个地球。
And when Krishna is glorifying the land of Vrindavan, he particularly wants to glorify the gopis of Vrindavan, not just gopis of any other place.But the gopis of Vrindavan.
Krishna 在荣耀 Vrindavan 之际，实际上他更想荣耀那些 gopi 们，而只是 Vrindavan 的 gopi， 而不是别的地方的 gopi。
So the goddess of fortune, she cannot get the same opportunity as the gopis.
幸运女神们得不到。Gopi 们那样的幸运的机会。
The gopis are more fortunate than the birds and the animals because Krishna will embrace them.
Gopi 们比那文达文的鸟类和动物更为幸运，因为他们得到了 Krishna 的拥抱。
So the gopis, they receive the same opportunity as all the others.Because Krishna also touches the gopis with his feet and also with his hands, and he also glances at them. But the gopis also, they get the special favor of Krishna's embrace.
Krishna 对那些动物一样的机会，因为他们也得到 Krishna 的莲花族的触碰。他的手的触碰和他的瞥视，但是 Krishna 得到了更加特殊的仁慈，因为他们得到 Krishna 的拥抱。
So the gopis are Krishna's most favorite devotees.
所以公平们是 Krishna 最喜爱的人。
So Krishna is saying, he's saying that Vrindavan, because of Vrindavan, earth has become very glorious.
Krishna 说，由于 Vrindavan, 所以这个地球显得特别的光荣。
And the treasure of Vrindavan, there at the lotus feet of Krishna.
而这个文达文的财富就在于 Krishna 的莲花足。
Whenever the peacocks hear Krishna play the flute, then the peacocks will dance madly.
孔雀一旦听到 Krishna 的笛音，立刻就会疯狂的起舞。
And whenever they see Krishna, they all become stunned.
他们一看到 Krishna 立刻被惊得目瞪口呆。
So Maharaj Parikshit has been speaking about the gopis and about their mood and their love for Krishna, and it's inspired him to speak some more of the prayers which the gopis sing about Krishna.
所以 Maharaj Parikshit 就在描述 gopi 们对 Krishna 的心态和对 Krishna 的爱。这就激发了他，来描述更多有关于 gopi 们。
So when the gopis hear the song of Krishna playing the flute as he walks into the Vrindavan forest, so this way it attracts the attention of all the gopis.
就当 Krishna 吹奏着他笛子穿越文达文森林的时候，这个笛音就传到了 Gopi 们的耳中，就吸引了他们的心。
They all began to think about their rasa, their relationship with Lord Krishna.
他们不由自主的就是联想起自己跟 Krishna 的 rasa, 跟 Krishna 的关系。
So one of the gopis said to Radharani that Vrindavan, because of Vrindavan, this earth planet has become glorious.
其中一位 gopi 就对 Radharani 说道，由于 Vrindavan, 这个地球变得至为光荣。
It's more glorious than any planet in the universe, because Krishna has put his lotus footprints everywhere in Vrindavan. Bhakti yoga, blissful devotional service.
Krishna 给予 Vrindavan 的居民们 Bhakti yoga, 奉爱，极乐的奉献服务。
We should understand that when Krishna marked Vrindavan, he wasn't wearing shoes, he was going barefooted everywhere.
我们要明白，当主 Krishna他在文达文的时候，他没有穿鞋，他是光着脚的，所以他的足印呢就留在了文达文的每一个地方。
And so the ground in Vrindavan, there are many stones and thorns, so it's not very easy to walk barefoot. But Krishna was so kind; he touched all the earth of Vrindavan with his lotus feet.
在土地上。文达文的地面上也有那些石子和荆棘，所以光着脚赤足走在这个土地上不那么容易。但 Krishna 是如此的仁慈，他就用他的莲花足触碰了地表。
And the Krishna, when Krishna appears in other places, when like Lord Vishnu appears sometimes in heavenly planets on other places, these are only avatars.But the Krishna who appears in Vrindavan, He's the source of all the avatars.
So when Krishna is in other places, 就是当 Vishnu 显现在天堂的时候，这只是 Krishna 的一个化身而已。但是 Krishna 显现在 Vrindavan 的时候，他是所有化身的源泉。
So Krishna is not just avatar, he's avatari, he's the source of all the avatars.
Krishna 不是一位 avatar, 他是 avatari,他是化身的源头。
So the gopis just need to call Krishna as Devaki Sutta, meaning the son of Devaki. And this way it proves that this is enough to say that Krishna has raised Vrindavan, he's brought Vrindavan to the highest platform, higher than that of any heavenly planet.
Gopi 们他们称呼 Krishna 是 Devaki Sutta, 意思是 Devaki 的儿子。这个称呼足以证明 Krishna 把 Vrindavan 就带到了最高的层面。
When Krishna appears other incarnations and other planets, they're never as fortunate as what Vrindavan is.
当 Krishna 以别的化身的形式显现，或者是显现在别的星球的时候，他从来没有像是 Vrindavan 这样，显现在 Vrindavan 的时候那样，把 Vrindavan 带到了一个高度。
When Krishna comes in other incarnations, he's the supreme controller. So it's not possible for him to walk around in his bare feet like what he does in Vrindavan.
When Krishna 以别的化身显现的时候呢，他是作为至高无上的控制者的身份显现的，并不是像他显现 Vrindavan 的时候那样是赤足显现在 Vrindavan。
So the gopis, although they know everything, but because they want to enjoy their love with Krishna, so they only see Krishna as the son of Yashoda. I mean, they don't see him in any other way.
虽然 gopi 们他们知道一切，但是因为他们想要享受与 Krishna 之间的爱的交流，所以他们只想把他看作是 Yashoda 的儿子，而不想把他看以别的方式来看待他。
Only in Vrindavan does Krishna appear as Govinda, the lord of the cows, who plays the place with the cows and wears a peacock feather and decorates himself with kadamba flowers.
Krishna 在 Vrindavan 之际，他是作为 Govinda, 母牛的主人的身份显现在 Vrindavan, 他和孔雀一起玩耍，他也用 Kadamba 的花来装饰自己。
And different things from the forest, they're ornaments for Krishna.
他也采集森林当中的不同的物品来装饰自己。
And in his hand, he's always holding his flute.
他的手总是拿着一只笛子。
So when the peacocks in Vrindavan, when they hear Krishna's flute, then they think that there's a dark cloud approaching, that it's going to rain, and they begin to dance.
他们的孔雀听到 Krishna 的笛音的时候，他们想，一片乌云即将来临，那即将下雨了，所以他们就开始起舞。
And when the peacocks dance, then all the other people, they may be on the mountain peaks, they stop whatever they're doing, they just stand there, they become stunned in ecstasy.
孔雀起舞之际，那些站在驻足在山顶的人们，他们就停下了他们的活动， 他们目惊得目瞪口呆。
And soon as the peacocks get a, as soon as they hear a little bit of Krishna's flute, then they start to dance wildly.
那些孔雀们，即便隐隐约约听到了 Krishna 一点，隐隐约的笛声，立刻就会开始疯狂的起舞。
So Krishna's flute has that mystic power, which captures the attention of the gopis.And makes them intoxicated.
Krishna 的就 Krishna 就拥有这样的玄秘力量，他能抓住勾皮们的注意力，使勾皮们浑然忘我。
So the peacocks are the first to be affected, but its effect actually goes everywhere. It affects living entities everywhere.
孔雀是第一个受到影响的生物，但实际上 Krishna 的笛音是影响了它的影响力是遍透整个 Vrindavan 的。
Another way we can also understand is that because Govardhan is very beautiful and always visible to the people of Vrindavan.So when they do Govardhan Puja, all the people, they all want to make offerings for Govardhan Puja, to offer to Govardhan.
而且每一个生物都能看见高尔丹山，所以当高尔丹铺着在进行的时候，每一个人都想来前来向高尔丹山献上供奉。
And that was when Krishna appeared, and he appeared on the Govardhan hill, and he said, "I am this hill," and he began to eat all the offerings.
正因为这个原因。Krishna 就显现在 Govardhan 山的山顶，说道：“我就是 Govardhan 山。”随后他开始吃掉贡品。
And we should also understand that in Vrindavan, the lower modes like passion and ignorance, they cannot act there. In Vrindavan, it's only the pure mode of pure goodness.
还要理解的是，在 Vrindavan 那些低等的激情和愚昧属性是不起作用的，在 Vrindavan 起作用的只有纯粹的善良属性。
Yeah, the trees and the creepers in the forest, full of fruits and flowers. That this is actually Lord Vishnu. That this they're manifested by Lord Vishnu.
Vrindavan 到处都生长着树木、爬藤，这些树木都开满了鲜花，结满了果实，这实际上是主威士努的展示。
So the branches of the trees, they bend low due to the weight of the fruits.
由于树上结满了果实，所以被他们把树枝都压弯了腰。
But the trunks and the vines, they're erect, they're straight, because they're in ecstasy of love of God.
而树干却挺直着，因为他们是由于对神的爱，爱的狂喜，所以他们都直立着。
So the trees and the creepers, they're both.Pouring down a rain of nectar.
树木爬藤都泼洒着甘露的这个汁液。
Okay, we will stop here.
好，那我们接下来会看一下问题。 个问题是来自于 CM 顶拜玛拉吉，感谢您的仁慈。我读博迦瓦坛看到书里说主 Krishna 离开文达文，但又说主 Krishna 没离开文达文，始终跟勾皮在一起。既然在一起，为什么勾皮还去库鲁切切手战场寻找 Krishna 呢？我记得之前我们去朝拜库鲁之野，当时那里的人讲了勾皮去战场看 Krishna 现脸。Oh, Basis Maharaj, thank you for your mercy. Yesterday I read Bhagavatam, and they said that Krishna left Vrindavan, but it is also said that Krishna never leave Vrindavan, and Krishna is always with gopis. They are together. Why gopis went to Kurukshetra to search for Krishna? I remember previously we went to visit Kurukshetra, and the people there have narrated about gopis. They went to the battlefield to see Krishna. Thank you.
Well, yes, well, the point is that Krishna was externally manifest. They could see the gopi, they could see Krishna face to face. But then Krishna left Vrindavan to go to Mathura, and from Mathura he went to Dwarka. And then later on, when Krishna came to Kurukshetra, he called the gopis to come and meet him.
Krishna 就离开文达文去了马图拉，进而他又去了杜尔卡，之后 Krishna 去了库鲁之野战场，他就叫勾皮们来那个战场上来见他。
So Krishna always resides in Vrindavan, but he's in Vrindavan hidden in the hearts of the gopis. So you don't see him, you can't see him face to face very easily, unless you're very, very, very pure.
Krishna 确实居住在文达文，但是呢，他是把自己藏在了勾皮们的内心，所以就不那么容易可以面对面的见到 Krishna， 除非一个人是非常非常非常的纯粹进步的。
We can also understand that Krishna in Vrindavan is Shamsundar Krishna. And so Shamsundar Krishna, he never leaves Vrindavan.
We must understand that Vrindavan's Krishna is Shamsundar Krishna. Shamsundar Krishna is always not leaving Vrindavan.
And the Krishna goes to Mathura and Dwarka, that's Vasudev Krishna. So, the gopis, their relationship, of course, is with Shamsundar Krishna.
那些勾皮们，和勾皮们有关系的是 Shamsundar。Krishna.
When Krishna came back from Dwarka to Kurukshetra, there was a solar eclipse. So Krishna had sent a letter to the people of Vrindavan. He was telling them, the gopis, that he would come to Kurukshetra and he wanted to meet them. So he told that the gopis should come. They said the cowherd boys, they don't need to come because they already came with Krishna when he went to Mathura for the wrestling match. At that time, the gopis stayed back. So now, this time at Kurukshetra, it's the turn of the gopis to come and meet Krishna. And the cowherd boys, they had to stay in Vrindavan, take care of the cows.
So, when Krishna was in Dwarka, 他后来就有一次发生了日食，然后 Krishna 就写信给 Vrindavan 的 Gopi 们，请要求他们来库鲁之野战场上来见自己。他告诉Gopi 们来见自己，但是告诉那些牧牛童们不要来。因为当时 Krishna 去 Mathura 去参加摔跤比赛的时候，那牧牛童们已经随同 Krishna 就去了。当时呢 Gopi 们是留在了 Vrindavan， 而这次该轮到 Gopi 们去见主 Krishna 了，而那些牧牛童们他们则留在 Vrindavan 来照料母牛。
So when the Gopis met Krishna at Kurukshetra,They were not so satisfied because he didn't seem like the same Krishna that they knew.
而当 Gopi 们来到库鲁之野来见 Krishna 的时候，他们感到内心不满足。因为这位 Krishna 不是他们当初认识的、了解的那位 Krishna.
They liked Krishna. They wanted to see Krishna as a cowherd boy.With the flute, with the peacock feather. They wanted to see him in the dress as a cowherd boy, but they saw him instead, they saw him as a prince.
Gopi 们喜爱的 Krishna 呢是那位头插孔雀羽毛手持笛子的牧牛童 Krishna. 他们喜欢见到的是那个 Krishna.而眼前站在自己面前的是一位王子形象的 Krishna.
So when the gopis met Krishna there at Kurukshetra, they wanted to bring him to Vrindavan.
所以当 gopi 们在战场上见到 Krishna 的时候，就立刻想把 Krishna 带回 Vrindavan.
So it said the first Rath Yatra took place there at Kurukshetra.
So it is said the first Rath Yatra took place at Kurukshetra.
And because Rath Yatra is performed in the mood of bringing Krishna back to Vrindavan.
Because the 举办弹车节的这个心态就是把 Krishna 带回 Vrindavan 的这种心态。
So, of course, you say Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. Yeah, he never leaves, but sometimes he's manifest and other times he's not manifest. So that when he's not manifest, he's still there in Vrindavan, but.He's in the heart, you can't see him face to face. So that's why the gopis wanted to bring him back to Vrindavan.
你说 Krishna 永远不离开 Vrindavan, 这也是对的。但是 Krishna 呢，他有时候是展示着的，有的时候是不展示的。所以当 Krishna 他不展示的时候呢，他是在gopi们的心中。那个时候呢，人们是无法面对面的来看见他的，所以呢 ，gopi 们就想把他带回 Vrindavan 了。
Okay.
好，你看下一个问题是 ，Panchatattva Prabhu， 明白 Maharaj 翻译主持人和所有奉献者，现在地球大灾难不断，这是为了减轻负担吗？这是主 Krishna 的意愿吗？Panchatattva Prabhu paid obeisance to you and the host and all devotees. He said that now on this earth, the disaster is coming one after another. Is this to eliminate the burden of the earth, or is it the will of Lord Krishna?
Well, you could say it's both. It's the will of Lord Krishna.And it's also to eliminate the burden on the earth.
这两个都成立，就这两个。你可以说它既是主 Krishna 的意志，也是主 Krishna 为了减轻这个地球的负担。
Certainly, we have to understand everything that happens is the will of Krishna.
毫无疑问，我们要理解一切的发生背后都是主 Krishna 的意志。
Right, we say in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "Mayadhyakshina prakriti suyate sacharacharam." This material nature is moving under my direction, O son of Kunti. So the material nature does not act independently; it's under the control of Krishna.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中，主 Krishna 说。这个物质自然在我的指挥之下运作，所以物质自然它不是独立运作的，物质自然是处在主 Krishna 控制之下。
Now Srila Prabhupada had warned us many times. He told us, he said, you know, this industrialization program and program of, you know, for economic development, it cannot go on.Forever.
释迦牟尼佛曾经屡次警告过我们世人，就这些工业活动还有经济发展的活动是不能永远进行下去的。
Now, previously, before industrialization, the planet was more based on agriculture.People lived in villages and they produced their own food.
在工业化革命之前呢，那整个这个地球上，它主要是依靠农耕。人们呢生活在村庄里，他们会生产自己的粮食。
But we've created a very artificial environment for ourselves.And that's the problem. That's why we're having all these difficulties.
但是后来呢，人们却为自己创造了一个人为的环境，非自然的环境，所以呢，他们就为自己创造了这些问题。
And we're trying to solve it all, of course, with our technology. You know, we think, oh, we have a disease.And so they think, oh, we'll have a vaccine, make a vaccine, and that will protect us. But we see, it doesn't work. It's not working like that. So we have to understand we are not the supreme controller. We are under the control of the material energy.
我们看到的事实是我们并非至尊的控制者，我们处在物质能量的控制之下。
This material energy belongs to Krishna. It's meant to be used in his service.It's meant to be used in the proper manner. It's not meant to be just used for our sense gratification and for our exploitation.
这个物质能量属于 Krishna, 要用来服务 Krishna, 而且以正确的方式来运用物质能量服务 Krishna. 物质能量不应该用于我们自己的感官享乐。而且我们人类不应当剥削物质能量。
And so we can see how we have created a lot of problems on the planet, that because of man, because of the things we've done, we've created many problems on the planet, the pollution and the different seasons also, there's no more harmony. We've ruined the different land. We've taken so much land, which was good agricultural land, and we take it to use it for building big factories. And the rivers all become polluted, And we take all, and we want to take more and more fish out of the sea.
那么看到了现在问题层出不穷，那这是由于人类自己自作自受，人们还在污染着环境，然后季节也不正常了，大自然并不和谐，很多的耕地都被取消来建立大工厂，河流受到污染。 人们想越来越多的来捕捞海里的鱼类。
We've been warned before about the overheating of the planet and how the different ice caps and peaks of the mountains are melting because the planet is becoming hotter.
以前人们就 已经发出过这种地球变全球变暖的警告，那么看到现在那个冰川都在融化，然后覆盖着白雪的冰川的山顶都慢慢的露出了土地。
So the present situation is giving all of us a chance to stop and to think more about life. And about the real purpose of life. Where are we going? What is our goal?
目前这个机会，目前的处境，就提供了人们一个良机，让人们停下脚步，来思考一下生命的目标，思考一下他们该何去何从，来思考一下他们的目的到底何在。
This planet Earth is place of karma, where we are earning our karma. It will determine our future, where we will take our future births.
这个星球地球是一个karma之地，果报的地方。所以在这个地球上，人们就会决定他们未来的投生是什么样的。
So we want to be very thoughtful and careful and understand that Krishna is giving us all an opportunity to think more carefully about the purpose of our life, that it's not meant for simply economic development and sense gratification.
我们要明白，这是 Krishna 给我们的一个机会，让我们能理解人生的目标，不是感官享乐和经济发展。So
human life is the opportunity for self-realization, to understand our real self, and to perfect this existence, to finish the life of birth and death in the material world.
人体生命是获得自我觉悟的良机，要使人们应该利用这个机会明白他们真实的自我，并且来完善他们的，结束他们物质生活的存在，结束他们的生死轮回。We
should not want to come back to this material world.
我们不应当希望还要回到这个物质世界。We
should want to finish taking birth and dying in the material world. We want to go back to the spiritual world, to an eternal life of bliss and knowledge.
我们应当希望结束生死轮回，投生和死亡，回到灵性世界。 过上永恒、真实和极乐的生活。那下一个问题是，CM，Gopi去战场看到的是 Vasudeva Krishna， 那是不是 Krishna 想给他们展示另一种情感呢？ This is continue with the previous question that the gopis went to the battlefield. They saw Vasudeva Krishna. Does that mean that Krishna want to show them another emotion?
Well, it means that the gopis are not very satisfied to see Vasudeva Krishna. They're in love with Shamsundar Krishna. Their relationship is with Shamsundar Krishna, not Vasudeva Krishna.
这意味着他们见到，他们不满足于见到 Vasudeva Krishna. Gopi 们的关系是和 Shamsundar 的关系。
The gopis, they enjoy the highest loving relationship with Krishna. And that's with Shamsundar Krishna, not with the opulence which is there in Dwarka or Vaikuntha. The gopis are in Vrindavan, the mood of Vrindavan. The mood of the gopis is Vrindavan. And the mood of Vrindavan is this highest rasa with Krishna, which is exchanged with Vasudev, but not with Vasudev Krishna, but with Shamsundar Krishna.
Gopi 们享受的是，跟 Krishna 最高的关系，是享受的是跟 Shamsundar Krishna 的关系，而不是 Dwarka 的百 Dwarka 富裕的 Dwarka 和 Vaikuntha 的，这种关系。Vrindavan 的 Gopi 们，他们的心态是享受的是，跟 Krishna 最高的关系 Rasa。他们交流的对象不是 Vasudeva Krishna， 他们交流的对象是 Shamsundar Krishna。
With Vasudeva Krishna, there's opulence and there's awe and veneration. There's not the intimacy which is there in Vrindavan.
Vasudeva 跟 Vasudeva Krishna 展示的是富裕，所以跟他之间的是一种敬畏的关系。而在 Vrindavan 的 Shamsundar Krishna 呢，跟他建立的是一种亲密的关系。
So the gopis, they like the intimacy of Vrindavan, to be very close and very affectionate with Krishna.But with Vasudeva Krishna, Krishna's the prince and he sits on the throne and you offer respect from a distance, you don't get close.
Gopi 们他们喜欢在近处就是爱 Krishna, 而 Vasudeva Krishna 是一位王子，他高高的坐在宝座上，人们要远远的向他致敬，而不能接近他。
So naturally, you'd want to be back in Vrindavan with Krishna in Vrindavan.
自然而然的，他们就想回到 Vrindavan， 想回在 Vrindavan 跟 Krishna 交流。
好，
下一个。也是来自于 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and all devotees present. Please accept my humble obeisance, O Lord, to Srila Prabhupada. Is Krishna higher than karma? Or does he in some cases also follow karma? For example, won't he decide who to give mercy and who does not? 这个问题来自 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj.所有奉献者接着我谦卑的顶拜，荣耀归帕帕的。Krishna 是不是高于 karma， 高于果报活动，或者是在某些情况下 ，Krishna 也要遵守karma？ 例如，当他决定给谁仁慈，不给谁仁慈的时候 ，Krishna 是不是也要遵守果报活动的原则呢
？Devotional service has nothing to do with.Karma has nothing to do with devotional service. Devotional service is above karma.
Karma, 公益性活动跟奉献服务毫无关系。奉献服务超越于公益性活动。
Krishna is controlled by devotion, not by karma.
Krishna 被奉爱控制，而不是被功利所控制。
You don't become a devotee by karma. You become a devotee by the mercy of a devotee.
人不能通过功利活动成为奉献者。人成为奉献者是由另外一个奉献者的仁慈。
Karma will not help you to get near to Krishna or to have a relationship with Krishna.
Karma, 果报不能帮助一个人接近 Krishna, 跟 Krishna 建立关系。
Krishna wants you to surrender, to give up everything and take shelter of him.
Krishna, 他希望你臣服，放弃一切，托庇于他。
So you may be a great king, you may be very wealthy, that won't help you to get devotion for Krishna.
一个人也许是国王或者是富人，但都不能帮助他获得对 Krishna 的奉爱。
Kamsa was a king, Krishna killed him.
Kamsa 是一个君主， Krishna 杀了他。
And look at Duryodhana, Dhritarashtra, they were also kings. Krishna didn't like them.
看看独优大还有 Dhritarashtra, 他们都是了不起的君王，但是 Krishna 却不喜欢他们。
Okay, 下一个问题。
问一的八题，顶拜 Gurudev， 请问。Krishna 为什么选择在 Vrindavan 显现 ？Krishna 赐族显现有什么意义的 ？Obeisance Gurudev， Why Krishna select to choose to appear in Vrindavan？ What's the purpose of Krishna appear barefoot in Vrindavan？
Krishna appeared in Vrindavan because Vrindavan is his favorite place.Because there's many trees there, beautiful trees and flowers and fruits, and there's many, many cows, and because the people are all his devotees.
Krishna 选择在 Vrindavan 显现是因为 Vrindavan 是他最喜欢的、喜爱的地方。Vrindavan 有树木、花、鲜花、果实、母牛遍地，那里人人都是他的奉献者。
And what's the second part?
What's the importance that for Krishna to do not wear shoes?
Well, traditionally, people don't wear shoes. Generally, you know, people didn't worry about wearing shoes. They would simply walk everywhere in their bare feet. It's very healthy. If you walk barefooted, you get a lot of exercise. Sometimes people, they will walk on different stones because within the sole of their feet, there are many different pressure points. And it's like an it's like a pressure, like you do, you know, acupressure. And so you walk barefooted, you get it's very good for health, you get a lot of massage on the different things in the body, different organs in the body by walking barefooted. So people in the past, a long time ago, they didn't bother to wear shoes.
Under 传统就是人们并不在乎要穿鞋，因为光着赤足走路对身体健康有益。人们可赤足可以得到锻炼。他有的人故意还要踩那些石头，因为足底有很多穴位，有的穴有的针灸呢。专家医生会专门 针对足底的穴位来治疗人们，所以可以有助于帮助人们按摩足底。因为这个跟全身的器官和全身都是有联系的，如果光着脚的话，他们对健康全身的健康有益，所以过去的人们他们并不会在意要故意刻意要穿上鞋的。
Mother Yashoda, one day she told Krishna, I'm going to get you a pair of shoes and an umbrella. But Lord Krishna said, well, if you're going to get shoes for me and an umbrella for me, I want you to get the same for my cows. Each and every one of my 900,000 cows, they need shoes and an umbrella. He said, I cannot take shoes and umbrella unless they also have shoes and umbrella.
曾经呢，亚瑟的妈妈，说对 Krishna 说，他要给 Krishna 带一把伞，穿上一双鞋子，然后 Krishna 就回答他妈妈说，如果你要让我拿伞啊，穿鞋子，你要给我的900,000头母牛，每一头母牛呢都带一把伞，都穿上鞋子，除非我的那些母牛他们每一头都穿鞋子，否则我自己不穿。
So Vrindavan, you know, if you go walking in Vrindavan, you know, every year during the month of Kartik, they have what is called the Braja Mandal Parikrama, when they walk through all the 12 forests of Vrindavan for 1 month. And it's encouraged, you know, traditionally,Everybody would walk barefooted.
在文达文卡尔提克月，有一整个月都是Raja Mandala 的 program， 这一个月要绕拜12座森林，人们被鼓励着就是光脚赤足绕拜整个12座文达文的森林。
Of course, it's not very easy because, as we heard,There are many stones and thorns, just as in the times of Lord Krishna, there were stones and thorns. So the stones and thorns are still there.
这么做不是那么容易的，因为地上会有石子啊，还有刺尖的荆棘刺，所以在 Krishna 那个时候就有石子，还有这种荆棘。所以这些石子荆棘到至今还留在了文达文。
And nowadays, of course, also we have roads, and roads are made with tar and so on, and they're very abrasive on the feet. And so you walk barefooted on these tar roads and asphalt roads, it rubs away the feet. It's not very good for the feet. But if you walk on the earth, on the ground, the earth, actual earth, then that's good.
在当今的现代的文达文呢，人们修了马油路、柏油路，走在这个柏油路上，水泥路上，就是这个赤脚走是不太舒服的。但是如果赤脚走在这个柔软的泥地上，对人们是可以感到很舒适的。下一个问题还是 CM， Narayana 和 Vishnu 是一个人，能否说幸运女神是 Narayana 的妻子，也是 Vishnu 的妻子，说法是一样的吗？是吗
？Yes。
是的。
一样。
一样。
下一个问题。
下一个，顶拜 Gurudev 可不可以理解？感谢您，可不可以理解？为 Krishna 现在以超灵形式依然藏在我们每个人内心呢？ Can we understand that Krishna still hidden himself in the heart of each one of us in the form of the super soul?
Yes.
可以。
But generally the super soul is Krishna's expansion, you see. But in the case of the gopis,It's not just the super soul, it's Krishna himself.
心的超灵是 Krishna 的扩展，但是对于 Gopi 们来说，不是超灵在他们心中，而是 Krishna 本人在他们内心。
Yeah.
我们现在修习 Krishna 知觉是回稳当的去见 Krishna 吗？Now we are practicing Krishna consciousness. The purpose is to go back to Vrindavan to see Krishna.
Yes, we hope so.
是的，希望是如此。
Now some people they may be attracted more to Dwarka. Some people may cultivate more their relationship with Krishna in Dwarka rather than Krishna in Vrindavan. You have that choice. Everybody has their choice.
有的人的跟 Krishna 的关系是跟 Dwarka 的 Krishna 的关系，而不是 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 的关系。所以每个人他们都有各自的选择权。
So, people have different moods. You see, some people are attracted to Krishna, Leela, and Vrindavan, and some people are more attracted to Krishna in Dwarka. They prefer Krishna where Krishna's married. Krishna in Vrindavan, you see, is not married, he's not with his wives, he's just with the gopis. It's a different rasa. Its relationship with the gopis is outside of marriage.But Krishna in Dwarka, his relationship with the queens of Dwarka, they're married.
在 Vrindavan 的消时光和 Krishna 在 Dwarka 的 Krishna 是不同的心态。Krishna 在 Vrindavan 呢，他是未婚，是跟 Gopi 们是这种婚外情。而在 Dwarka 的 Krishna 呢，他是跟他的王后之间的这种已婚的感情，他们是不同的 rasa 关系。
We should understand Vasudev Krishna and Shamsundar Krishna are both Krishna. It's the same person, but just a different mood.
我们要理解 Vasudev Krishna 和 Shamsundar Krishna 是同一个人。他们只是不同的心态、情感。
Krishna reciprocates with the different devotees. Some devotees, they want to have that relationship with Krishna in the mode of Dwarka, and others more attracted to Vrindavan.
Krishna 会回报不同的奉献者，有的奉献者希望跟 Dwarka 的 Krishna 建立关系，而有的奉献者更被 Vrindavan 的 Krishna 所吸引。下一个 CM Krishna 有无限的名字，有没有最最最原初的名字？ Continue with the question. Krishna has unlimited names. Does Krishna have the most original name?
Yes.
有。
Yes, Krishna is the original name. Krishna, Govinda, that's the original name.
Krishna 就是最最最原初的名字， Govinda 也是。
Lord Brahma worships Krishna. Govinda Mahadipursham Tamaham Bhajami. That's at the beginning of the creation.
在创造之初的时候 ，Brahma 就写了，婆罗诃摩赞来赞美 Krishna， Govinda Adipurusham。
So Krishna.
Somebody.
Krishna Govinda is the original name. Somebody what?
因此，有人说是 Shamsundar， 有的人说是 Krishna， 到底哪一个名字是最最最原始的名字
？Well, Shamsundar is a description of Krishna, right? That Krishna's Shyamasundar, black and beautiful. That's a description of Krishna's qualities. Krishna has many names according to his different pastimes.
Shyamasundara 是对 Krishna 的描述，因为 Krishna 他肤色黝黑，他形象俊美，所以就用 Shyamasundara 来描绘 Krishna 的品质。根据 Krishna 不同的消失光， Krishna 是有不同的名字。
We see the name Shyamasundara is also there in the Brahma Samhita. It's also there, mentioned there. It's a Primanjana Charita Bhakti Vilochanena Santasa Deva Ridayishu Vilokayanti Yam Shyamasundaram Achinchagunam Swarupam Govinda Madhipursam Tamaham Bhajami. Lord Brahma is saying, I worship Govinda, the primeval Lord, who is Krishna, Shyamasundara himself, with inconceivable innumerable attributes.
在 Brahma 婆罗诃摩赞当中，有这样的诗节，我崇拜原始的主 Govinda， 他就是 Krishna, Shyamasundara 本人，他有着不可思议的品质。
But,The name of Krishna is the primary name. Krishna, Krishna, Govinda, they are the first two names. They're all primary names. There's primary names and secondary names. So Krishna, Govinda, Shyamasundara, these are all primary names, names of Krishna in relation to his qualities. It may also be,Nanda Nandana, Yashoda Nandana, names in relation to his devotees, these are also allowed. They're also there. They're also eternal names.
Krishna, Govinda, Shyamasundara, 这些都是原始的名字，他们被称为主要的名字，因为他们是跟描述的是 Krishna 的品质。Krishna 根据 Krishna 跟他的奉献者的关系，他也被称为 Nanda Nandana， 亚瑟的 Nandana， Nanda 的宠儿，亚瑟的宠儿，这也是允许的。他们都是永恒的名字。除此之外，还有 Krishna 次要的名字。
Secondary names are names like Jagat Ishwara, the controller of the world, or Brahman, Paramatma, these are all secondary names of Krishna. They're also describing Krishna, but they're not the primary names of Krishna.
除此之外， Krishna 还被称为 Jagat Ishwara, 就世界的控制者， Brahman, Fan, Paramatma, 超灵，这属于次要的名字。这些对 Krishna 的描述不是主要的名字，是次要的名字。
So we chant, we prefer to chant the primary names of Krishna.
我们喜欢唱诵 Krishna 的主要的名字。
Yeah. Okay.
好。下一个 Yogita Sharma Hare Krishna Gurudev please I send my humble obeisances of Lord to you Gurudev Srila Prabhupada and devotees of the Lord. When the gopis met Lord Krishna in Kurukshetra, they were not satisfied. They felt he wasn't the original Krishna. How about Lord Krishna known as Madhava in Mathur Dham?The gopis there are there as well. Will the gopis feel Lord Madhava is their original Krishna? 这个问题来自于 Yogita Sharma. Hare Krishna Gurudev, 请接受我卑微顶拜，荣耀归于您，荣耀归于 Prabhupada 的奉献者。当gopi们在库鲁之野战场上和主 Krishna 相遇的时候，他们感到并不满足，他们感到他不是原初的 Krishna。那么，在马普圣地马普的，被称为 Madhava 的主 Krishna 又如何呢？马普也有牧牛姑娘， 这些牧牛姑娘会不会感到 Madhava 就是他们原初的 Krishna 呢？
Well, it's not that they weren't satisfied. It's not the original Krishna. It was just not the Krishna they remembered from Vrindavan.
并不是因为，就是库鲁之血战场上的 Krishna 不是原初的主，他们内心不满足，而是原因是，就是在库鲁之血战场上的 Krishna 不是他们熟悉的记忆里的 Vrindavan 的 Krishna。
Yeah, they had their particular memories as young girls, as young gopis. They remembered Krishna in a particular way.And they saw that Krishna going to Dwarka, he was in a different mood, a different mellow. And the gopis preferred Krishna as he had been in Vrindavan.
那作为写他们 gopi 们还是小女孩子的时候，他们脑海中的特殊的印记，留在就是 Krishna， 在 Vrindavan 的这 Krishna， 就他的独特特征就留在了这些 Gopi 们孩童时代的那个记忆里。所以当 Krishna 去了 Dwarka 的时候，他的心态，他的这种情怀就不一样了。而这些 Gopi 们，他们宁愿想着 Vrindavan 的那位 Krishna。
So, in Mayapur, you have Radha Madhava. Mayapur is not different from Vrindavan. You have to understand.
In Mayapur, there is Radha Madhava 神像。但是您要明白，马普和文大们是没有区别的。
Yeah. All the holy places which are in Mayapur, all the holy places of Vrindavan, they're all here in Mayapur. They're not different. So Lord Krishna Madhava is here with the gopis, and the gopis are happy.
那所有的圣地都在马普。而且文大门的所有的地方马普也有，马普跟文大门有区别，因此勾皮们对马普的 Madhava 也是感到很满意的，跟他在一起也是快乐的。
When you look at the deities, you can see they're very happy.
当您去观看觐见神像的时候，你可以看得出来。
Because they're enjoying the loving service of all the devotees.
他们在享受所有奉献者的爱心服务。
Yes.
好，下一个问题来自于 L. 顶拜咕噜 ，Krishna 为什么在地球上选择 Vrindavan 而不是别的地方呢？
Yeah. Why does Krishna choose to live in Vrindavan? Why not some other place?
Yes.
Well, the reason is that just like a farmer has a piece of land, and he will pick a particular place where he wants to build his home, where he's going to live with his family. He will pick his favorite place, where he would like to be. So the same way Lord Krishna chooses his own favorite place, and he comes there.
就像一位农夫，他有田地，他会选择一个地方来盖房子和自己的家人居住在这个房子里。所以这位农夫呢，他会选择一块他最喜欢的地方来居住。所以他就选择了，所以 Krishna 也会选择他最喜欢的地方。
Actually, you should understand that Krishna brings this Vrindavan with him. Before he comes, that Vrindavan place actually appears there to make arrangements for Lord Krishna to come. When Lord Krishna comes there, he brings Vrindavan, and the, not only Vrindavan, but the Govardhan Hill, the Yamuna River, but they all come to facilitate Lord Krishna's pastimes.
实际上呢, Vrindavan 是 Krishna 带来的, 就是在 Krishna 显现之前, Vrindavan 就显现在这个地球上, 做出了安排, 好, 让 Krishna 能降临地球。 所以 Krishna 是带着 Vrindavan 一起来的, 他不仅带来了 Vrindavan, 还带来了 Govardhan 山, Yamuna 河。 所以他们是为了协助 Krishna 上演他自己的逍遥。
So Prabhupada said, you don't go to Vrindavan just by buying a ticket. Vrindavan is not just a place on the map.
Prabhupada 说过, 不能仅仅通过购买一张车票就去了 Vrindavan, 而且 Vrindavan 它也不是地图上的一块地方。
Vrindavan is the embassy of the spiritual world.
Vrindavan 是灵秀世界在住地球的大使馆。
So Krishna comes, he's going to perform his pastimes here with his devotees. He brings his own place for him to perform his pastimes. It's not material. The holy Dham is not the material world. The holy Dham is from the spiritual world.
So when Krishna wants to perform a pastime, he will bring his own place. Vrindavan is not a material place. It is a holy land. It is not belonging to the material world. It is from the spiritual world.
Of course, ordinary people go to Vrindavan, they don't see Vrindavan because they see with their material eyes. They cannot see the holy Dham.
普通人他们去Vrindavan的时候，他们看不见Vrindavan，因为他们用自己的肉眼去看。但是Vrindavan它不是一个物质的地方，它是圣地。So
there's a covering placed over the holy Dham. So the ordinary people, materialistic conditioned souls, they don't see the holy Dham. They just see the ordinary place. They just think of Vrindavan. They just think, oh, another Indian village. They don't see the actual holy Dham.
普通的物质主义的受条件限制的灵魂看不见圣地，他们把它当成另一个普通的印度村庄，他们看不见真正的圣地。Just
like the holy name, materialistic people, ordinary people, they may hear the holy name, they just think, oh, just a name, just a song, just mundane. They cannot understand the transcendental nature of the holy name.
好比圣名，物质主义者呢，他们把它仅仅当成一个名字、一个声音而已，他们把它当成一个世俗的声音，他们并不明白圣名的超然的本质。OK，
下一个问题。为什么狗皮生来就纯粹呢？ Why the gopis are pure from birth?
Yeah, why the gopis are pure from their birth?
Well, they come from the, some gopis come from the spiritual world. They're already pure. They come just to take part in Krishna's pastimes.
有些狗皮们是来自灵性世界的，他们就是纯粹的灵魂。他们下来参加 Krishna 消时光。
To take birth as a gopi, you have to be pure, you have to be free of all sins.
投生为狗皮必须得是纯洁的，摆脱了罪恶的。
Yes, Shai Gawanti.
为什么 Radharani 是 Krishna 的内在能量，还总是感受分离之情呢？ Why Radharani is the internal energy of Krishna, but still she feels the separation from Krishna?
Because there's more ecstasy in feeling separation.With the separation, after separation, then they meet. So when they meet, after being separated, they feel more ecstasy, more pleasure.
因为分在分离当分离之情当中有更多的狂喜，他们两个人分离之后，当他们在重新相遇的时候，他们会感受到狂喜，感受到更多的快乐。
Yeah, if you're with someone every day, then you don't appreciate them. But when they go away for some time, you meet them after a long time, you feel more pleasure to meet them. It's more exciting.
就好像你跟一个人天天见面，你就不会欣赏到他。如果你跟他分开了，过了很长一段时间。又重新相聚的时候，你会感受到非常的快乐，感到特别激动。
Yeah, 下一个问题。
CM 来，智性来自 Krishna， 智性也属于精微躯体。那智性是来自 Krishna 内在能量还是物质能量呢？ The intelligence comes from Krishna and.Is one of the subtle bodies. Does the intelligence comes from the internal energy or material energy of Krishna?
Well, it's described in the Bhagavad Gita that the intelligence, mind intelligence and false ego. Boom, huh? In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes the elements of material nature, earth, water, fire, air, ether,mind, intelligence, and false ego. Altogether, these eight comprise my separated material elements.
佛家梵歌说，土、水、火、空气、仪态、心意、智性、假我，这八者构成游离于我的物质元素。
So we understand intelligence in that way, that the intelligence is a material, of course.Within the spiritual body, you have spiritual intelligence, you have the soul, and the soul has its own intelligence.
所以我们能够明白智性它是物质的。当然了，灵性的身体里也有灵性的智性，它是灵性的。
But we're using our material intelligence, the material intelligence is directing the mind. Intelligence is used to discriminate what is good and what is bad.
物质的智性在指导着心意，我们来区分什么是好的，什么是坏的。
Okay.
下一个 Panchatattva Prabhu. Oh, thank you so much for your mercy, dear Maharaj Hare Krishna. Your Gita Shama. Gurudev, regarding COVID-19, can we just think when we will leave the body? When do so, COVID-19 is just an excuse for the suffering and death of the body to happen. When we will leave the body, when one has to do so. Yogita Sharma 说 Gurudev 有个关于新冠病毒，我们可不可以这样想，当一个人离开躯体的时候，他离开躯体的时候，新冠病毒只是就是躯体受苦和躯体死亡的缘由和借口。而且，当一个人必须这样，必须离开躯体的时候，他也就时间到了，他也就将离开了躯体。
Yes, we can think like that. We can think, but we can think also that if Krishna wants someone to live, we will live. If Krishna wants us to leave the body, we will leave the body. So the COVID-19 is another arrangement for us to leave the body. We know we have to leave the body one day. We take birth, we have to die. How we leave the body is not very important. What is important is where are we going after we leave the body.
可以这样理解，这个离开躯体是 Krishna 的安排。Krishna 安排这个新冠病毒人，一个人染上新冠病毒离开躯体，只要有生必有死，至于如何死亡，并不是重要的，重要的是死后灵魂的去向。
Yes， 下一个问题。
下。Evil 93顶拜 Guru 及奉献者们，没有 Krishna 知觉时，大都是在剥削利用物质的能量吧。Opposite Guru and devotees, without Krishna consciousness, most of the time people are exploiting and using material energy. Is that right?
Yes, right.
是的。
Very good.
很好。
下一个问题。
Bhakti 顶拜 Guru 翻译顶拜您所有奉献者，请问，首次弹车节是什么时候？为什么选择库之夜 ？Opposite Guru and all devotees. The first Radha Yatra is held. When was it?
Yeah. So it was 5,000 years ago when Krishna went there with the queens. He came from Dwarka. Krishna was on the planet living in Dwarka 5,000 years ago, and he came there to Kurukshetra, and they met the gopis. And so that's when the first Radha Yatra took place.
首届弹车节是5000年前，Krishna 携王后们从 Dwarka 去了库之野，然后那儿的奉献者就是举办了首届弹车节。
Because Kurukshetra is a holy place. It's a very important holy place. It's been a place of pilgrimage for many millions of years. Many great kings and sages went there to do austerity. So Krishna chose to come there to meet, to do that. He performed sacrifices, he met sages, he gave charity, and he could meet the gopis.
因为库支也是一个很重要的朝圣之地，上百万年来，他许多的圣王还有圣哲们就在那里苦行，所以 Krishna 呢，他也想去那里做祭祀布施，所以他就让 Gopi 们前来见自己。
Okay, yeah.
Vishnu 王朝是哪个国王管理？是 Vasudeva 所在的王朝吗
？Yes, Vasudeva.
Who is the king of Vishnu dynasty?
Who's the king? Well, there was what's the name? Vasudev's
Ugrasena?
Ugrasena, yeah, right. Ugrasena, thank you.
这个王朝是乌格森的国王管理。
Yeah, after the...Kamsa took out Ugrasen, made himself the king, but actually it was Ugrasen who should be the king.
Kamsa 就把乌格森那关起来了，然后自立为王。但实际上，乌格森那是真正的国王。
还有问题吗
？Vilha 是什么意思 ？What's the meaning of Vilha?
Of what?
Vilha.
I don't know what. How do you spell it?
She didn't spell it's a Chinese character.
I don't know what's the word meaning. I don't know. I never heard this word. What's that? Vil.
Vilha. 那您能不能把这个 Vilha 的梵文词打下来，拼读
？Vilha.
Next.
Yeah.
活动与 Karma Kanda 有何区别 ？What's the difference between activity and karma kanda.
Well, karma kanda activities are done for material benefit, for our sense gratification.
Karma kanda 是为了物质的好处来举行的，是为了感官享乐。
And they're done according to Vedic regulation, this particular manner in which the activities are performed and guided by the Vedas.
它是按照规则，按贝贝达经所指导来举行的。
Worshipping demigods and different things.
崇拜半神人啊，等等。
Hodong, that could be any kind of activity. And maybe according to Vedas, maybe not according to Vedas.
可能是任何的活动，也可能是伟达活动，也可能是非伟达的活动。
Mm-hmm. 还有呢？
She spelled that Vyuha, V-Y-U-H-A.
I don't know, but you have to tell me where the word is.What connection is she?
这词出自哪里？它上下文是什么？那我们下次看。真真，下一个。Three more questions. You have time?
We'll try.
晨晨 ，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 请问物质宇宙分多少层？灵魂世界是什么样的？How many levels material universe are divided? And what's the vision of the spiritual, what does spiritual world looks like?
So material world is divided into, there's 14 different levels of planetary systems in the material universe.
物质宇宙分为14个星系。
And spiritual world, well, Goloka Vrindavan is in the form of a lotus flower, and there are many unlimited Vaikuntha planets.Which are all brightly effulgent.
灵性世界的 Goloka Vrindavan 形状是一朵莲花的形状，然后灵性世界有无穷无尽的百昆特星球，然后它们都是放射着熠熠的光彩。
下一个问题。
下一个 ，Hare Krishna Dimai Gurudev， 感谢您，学习《博梵歌》第四章。32要说伟达经推荐各种祭祀是为了适合各种不同的活动者，人们持根深蒂固的躯体化概念，因此这些祭祀被特意安排使人能用躯体信念治理活动，但是这些祭祀最终目的是为了使人摆脱躯体获得解脱，这里的使人能用躯体信念治理去活动不懂，请教咕噜，感恩您。 Bhagavad Gita chapter 4 and verse 32.
Yeah.
It is said that the Vedas recommend various sacrifices for different activities. And because people have their bodily conception of life, and therefore these sacrifices are arranged specifically so that people can use their body, mind, and intelligence to do activity. But the ultimate goal is to make people to get rid of their body and to get liberation. So I cannot understand what does mean that so that people can use their body, mind, and intelligence to do activity. Because people have their bodily conception of life, therefore these sacrifices use their body, mind, and intelligence to do activity.
Well, we use body, mind, and words. When we use body, mind, and words in the service of Lord Krishna or in devotional service, then that is liberation. That is a liberated soul, one who uses the body, mind, and words for the service of the Supreme Lord. Then he is actually a liberated soul in this world, in this body.
We use our own body, mind, and words.来服务 Krishna， 服务至尊主 Krishna， 这个就是奉献服务，这就是就已经成为了解脱的灵魂，就是指的在这个世界上，在这个躯体当中。The next.
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. 亲爱的 Gurudev, 真真顶拜您，甜美莲花组顶拜您。请问 Guru, 祭祀是一种布施吗？我买的衣服和物品可不可以供奉？是不是买回来家用品都可以供奉呢？Business, Guru, does sacrifice is kind of a charity? I bought some clothes.Items, can I also offer it?
Yes. Sacrifice is also, charity is one kind of sacrifice. You bought some clothes, yes, you can also offer it to Krishna and pray to Krishna that you will use them in Krishna's service. Now, usually when we offer clothes to Krishna, we won't just offer any clothes, but we will offer devotee clothes. So it should be proper dress that you're offering.
祭祀就是一种布施，您可以把买回来的衣服物品供奉，您可以向 Krishna 祈祷，祈求这样来服务 Krishna， 但不是任何衣服，而是奉献奉爱的那种服饰，这个是正确的供奉的服饰，不是随便的服饰。
Yes.
Okay. Yogita Shaman and Yuna Inna say thank you very much, Kumar. That's all. Vyuha. Vyuha.
Vyuha.
Shidu. Army. Kurukshetra. Is it the many? Is the meaning of many? Numerous.
What? Vyuha?
Expansion.Sumukhishrada said it's expansion. View of, view her team.
You have what? Team. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm not hearing. What did you say view her means?
In the chat box, Bhakti typed that, for example, view her.Small groups.
Chaturvyuha. We have the Chaturvyuha, the four expansions of the Lord in the spiritual world, you know? And there's Vasudev, Sankarshan, Aniruddha, and Prajumna. They're the Chaturvyuha. Chatur is four, and Vyuha, yeah, could mean group, yeah? A group of four. Vyuha. I'll look it up.
好，那这个问题我们下回再回答。跟我说看看，查一查。但
，Yeah.
Oh, 晨晨。灵世界的中心是什么样 ？What's the center looks like? The center of the spiritual world looks like.
The center of the center of the spiritual world is Goloka Vrindavan. We said it's a lotus flower, and in the center of the lotus flower is Goloka Vrindavan. So Goloka Vrindavan, you want to know what the center of the spiritual world looks like? It's exactly like Vrindavan.
The spiritual world, it looks like a lotus flower, right?
No, Goloka Vrindavan looks like a lotus flower.
Okay. Goloka Vrindavan 的形状是莲花的形状，然后它的中心就是 Vrindavan。那么灵性世界的中心就是样子，就是 Vrindavan 的样子。That's all.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you want me to share?Guru Mani Mataji, Kiwama Jantai Dapani, Woman Ganshir, Sati Mataji Jujar, Isa Krishna Kumari Jujar, Woman Ganshir Soyda Fung Shenza, Ling Ting, Tiwanti, Woman Jufu Niman, 那注意身体，多保重，那多念诵，注意 Krishna， Hare Krishna， Srila Prabhupada ki jai， Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki jai。